Hi Aquarius, this is your mid-September 2019 reading. Aquarius, the focus of September is very much on your financial resources, on your joint financial resources, as well as your skill set by which you earn your money. But the focus of second half of the month will look very different from the first half of the month, because the first half of the month was focused on joint situation, the situations in which you help others, you work with others, you resolve the joint financial issues, you work with others and sort of maybe even working through certain crisis situation or certain endings and coming out of that powerfully. The first half of the month was very much focused on house of endings, whereby the process of life and death or a rebirth is happening and a deep and personal emotional healing is achieved. We are moving out of an old dependency. We're letting go of an old phase of our life and trusting in our new phase of our life. We are experiencing the transformation that comes from trusting our own destiny. And in the second half of the month, we begin that destiny because your ruling planet Saturn is going direct on 18th of September, and that begins the rolling out of the new structure of life. Because Saturn rules the very structure of our life that we exist in. It rules the boundaries, it rules the regulation, it rules the administrative systems of the world. So when Saturn goes direct on 18th of September, the things that were held back in terms of new structures, in form of approvals, in form of the new landscape of our life, that starts evolving and moving forward. The things that were held back, that were causing us frustration, that was causing us sort of a feeling that why is this not moving forward, even though I have put my everything into it, those things start evolving and moving forward. So the last 4 months of frustration, resentment, arrested growth is finally coming an end. But the purpose of those last 4 months was to teach us something. It was to release our own resistance to the transformation we are about to get into. Because when Saturn is sitting in your house of 12th, of release, of moksha, this is the year of clearing out the old. This is the year when we face our own demons, our own unconscious behaviors, the things that have been holding us back, because now we are meant to progress forward to a very different phase of our life, because Saturn will be moving into your sign in March 2020, and that is the start of a completely new phase of your life. A whole new chapter of life will begin in 2020 when your ruler comes to your sign. Saturn is your ruler, and when it comes in your sign, that is a start of once in 30 years of a new chapter of life, because this happens once in 30 years. So a new chapter of your life is defined. What's happening right now this year, as I've mentioned in the last couple of videos, is that you're getting ready for that phase. This is a cadent year. This is a year in which we make progress by preparing for what's about to come. You're preparing to take on responsibility. You're preparing to take the next step. And as a part of that, leaving the past will be a key factor in that. And something might have come up this month to release that past in the first half of the month. And now in the second half of the month, we look towards the future and start creating that. Because Jupiter and Neptune are making their third and last contact this year on 21st of September. And Jupiter is showing you a very different vision of your life than you've seen before. Jupiter is expanding your social influence. The aim of Jupiter coming in your house of social influence first time in a decade is to expand your presence, expand your online presence, expand your influence socially, expand your business network, expand your friends' network. And how it's doing that is by you being out and about and meeting more and more with people, and people supporting you, and people coming in your presence who are influential, who can help you grow, people supporting you, you having a huge amount of support from your friends as well as from the business network. But at the same time, Neptune is dissolving your old way of deriving worth. It is creating a new sense of worth within yourself that you did not have before. It is dissolving the old way you used to derive confidence, used to derive faith in your future. It is sort of creating a new faith in yourself. which is not dependent on external applause, which is not dependent on external people. So there is a strong core that is getting created in terms of your self-worth and net worth. And you'll see more and more of that in the second half of the month, because we have a full moon in this area. And you see the result. You see the result of all the work you've done on yourself, on your skill set, on your self-worth, on your net worth. You'll see some result of that in the second half of the month when we have a full moon in this area on 14th of September. So from 14th of September to 28th of September, you see some financial rewards of what you have worked on so far over the course of last 6 months. It could be in form of you receiving something as a result of your skill set, or you completing a skill set that you have invested in, or you deriving worth from the work that you've done, which has value beyond money. Because when Neptune is ethereal, Neptune is a planet that sort of makes us go to the heights we have never gone before. It's inspirational. So when Neptune is sitting in your house of finances and material resources, it makes you derive value out of things that are ethereal, that fill your heart, that make you feel that you have done and contributed something valuable to the society. So there is a value that is derived out of the work that you have done that is beyond the tangible assets that it's generating, that is seen in the second half of the month. It makes you feel confident. It makes you feel happy about what you're doing. It fills you up in the ways that it has not filled before. So it is dissolving any outer security, but it is creating an inner security that you never thought you will have. The ownership of an asset and ownership of material resources, all of that is possible. Money is possible, but this is not where you will be deriving value from, in my view. You are deriving value from a very different source of income that you have done before. This is creative in nature. This could be spiritual in nature. This could be away from what you have done before. This is something which is stepping out of the norm. It could be even a little bit ahead of time. You're generating value of something that is a little bit unique. And it is giving you huge amount of faith in your future. Because it's coming with a release of fear. It is coming from a release of clearing out of outdated attachment fears and our own undoing, which was stopping us from being all we can be. There is a very positive healing and release that comes with this, which is very deep, very personal, very emotional. There's a letting go with this full moon that comes that you will experience in your soul, because Saturn, Pluto and South Node, they're coming together in your inner journey. They're restructuring, rewiring who you are a person when nobody is watching. Your faith is getting stronger. Your sense of purpose is getting stronger. Your soul is getting stronger. Your soul is getting imbibed into the work that you're doing. When Saturn is in our house of faith or spirituality, this is the time, it's the timing of God or the higher powers that you consider. Our ego is dissolved. We are reborn in our origins. There's a freedom from fear, from unconscious beliefs, because we are meant to walk on the path that we have not walked before. So there is a little bit of strong faith within ourselves that is required, and detachment from what we have been in the past that is required. The patterns that we have in the past exhibited as a person, that has to be released, and our drive, our hidden desires, our hidden strength, it comes out. We come face to face with our fears as we want more, and we are asked to surrender to something which is bigger than us. We have to give in to the molder here, because, you know, our story is bigger than what it has been in the past when these aspects come together. Saturn moving direct, your ruler moving direct, feels like things start finally moving forward. And that is the key theme of second half of the month all the way till December. Things will have a speed of their own in evolving, in moving forward as we progress forward from the second half of the month. this Jupiter-Neptune square of creating social influence that is happening around 17 degree. So if you have planets around 17 degree, which is around 6th of February born, if you're Aquarius Sun, you'll feel that very strongly from 15th of September to around 28th of September. It could be some project that you've been working on that has money attached to it as well as social influence attached to it that finally gets birthed, that finally is given birth to. After a lot of falling back and getting back again and then revising and reviewing them, that finally comes into motion. Thing to be careful about, Uranus is going to be making a difficult aspect with our personal planets in second half. So there'll be a restlessness within ourselves. It could be us who are restless, or it could be somebody in our family who is having a little bit of different opinion from ourselves, and there could be a little bit of a difficult period or a period of adjustment that is required with your sense of freedom. You might be traveling a lot, or you might be wanting to sort of pursue this fully, and there is some holding back of it from your family, or there could be a conflict over it, which is very much possible. Because there is something which is changing in your home and family at the same time when you want to transform things in your business, in your work, you want to travel. Those two things might be at a little bit of clash on specific dates, especially if you have planets around 6 degree of Aquarius, which is around 26, 27, 28th of January born, around those dates. So if you're January born Aquarius or around 6th degree of Aquarius, you want to be careful on 17th of September. You want to be careful around 19th of September and then again on 28th of September. Uranus is sitting in your house of home and family, so your home and family structure and possibly your place of living needs to evolve with the new life that you're getting onto. So it's possible that you need to find a home away from home. Maybe you need to find peace away from home. Maybe you need to move suddenly. Maybe there are changes in your home and family life or in the life of your parents that is coming about. So there is some amount of sudden shifts and changes that might have been highlighted to you in the past couple of days in your home and family. And now this new adventure that you're planning to get onto, that you're working towards, that you're finally getting the strength within yourself and the external support to move forward with, that might clash with those home and family changes. And the reason for that to be highlighted is that we are being told that our inner life has to change to reflect our outer progression. Our family structure or the way to be being with the family is possibly needs changing. It possibly needs changing. Maybe you need to move the house. Maybe you need to change the domestic routine. Maybe you need to change the way you connect with your family. Those things will be pointed out, especially if you're a January-born Aquarius or you have planets around 6th degree of Aquarius. What is happening apart from this is that we have this cardinal T-square being forming on 22nd and 25th of September, where you will be driven to do things in the new direction. You are a person on a mission after 22nd of September. After 22nd of September, Sun enters your house of purpose. After you have released this whole phase, you have realized how you want to make money and what is the influence you want to get into. Second half of the month, after 22nd of September, you are getting into a phase where your sense of adventure is woken up. You want to do things differently. You want to do things where you're taking leap of faith because you have found your faith. And that comes with certain cardinal distinct steps that are taken. On 22nd of September, you might be talking about it. 25th of September, you might be talking about it with somebody in your personal life, or you might be financially discussing this. This is especially true if you have planets around 14 degree of Aquarius, which is around 3rd of February born. But most of you will feel it. Cardinal T-square sort of jumps us into action, because we are going into summer solstice, we are going into winter solstice or fall or spring, a change in season on 23rd of September. And that brings us to a point where we want to change things in our life, where we want to take certain steps which are cardinal in nature, which are directional in nature, and we want to get things done. So you'll find yourself taking those steps, or at least planning them, on 22nd and 25th of September, and that brings you to a new start in October. Because on 28th of September, we have a new moon in your house of adventure, in your house of education, in your house of expansion of your career, which points to you taking certain steps to progress forward in your life. It could be that you're looking at publishing something. It could be that you're taking a course. It could be that you're working with a mentor. It could be that you're traveling and meeting people who are different from yourself, because you have decided your purpose in life is higher and you want to have a social influence. And because of that, you interact and meet with people who are completely different from you. This is especially true if you have planets around 5 degrees of Aquarius, which is around 26th of January born, or overall January born. We'll experience that from 28th of September all the way till 13th of October. You might be taking a journey which has a purpose to itself. You might be taking a journey which is based on your new faith in what you want to do. It could be a journey of the mind. It could be you just interacting with people who are different from you and you deciding to do something different with your life. Because the release that is coming this month of Saturn and then Pluto coming to play in October is not ordinary. This is the first time ever Saturn, Pluto and South Node are together sitting in your house of endings, in your house of higher powers. It is the time of higher powers. It is the time of God's will. It is the time when an old path is dissolved and new one created. We are getting prepared for that new path, and certain endings lead to certain new adventure, certain new thought processes, a spiritual growth, a faith growth, a commitment to a future which is different from what you have done before, and it has influence, social influence written all over it. So good luck for that, Aquarius, and I'll see you in the next video. There are the reset of this month with your Aquarius moon is happening around 10th, 11th and 12th of September. So we're doing this reading under your moon. Good luck for the new start that is about to come your way. Thank you.